The Upper Room Art Gallery is a nonprofit collaborative of artists and designers from around the world. We're all somehow involved in environmental issues or social justice and economic development projects. So we use our artwork and our careers as artists to help design products that can be made from people in extreme poverty and help to empower them out and on a new path in life. As a painter, I'm just a painter. I like to paint spiritual realities, things that I wouldn't be able to photograph, as like maybe what I feel are spiritual realities in the world, I would paint that. And if it could be photographed, I photograph it. So I also work in collaborative work, cultural events, such as the paddle up that we just did with the Miccosukee and Seminole tribe, and currently we're carving a dugout canoe right in the gallery, focusing on craftsmanship. It's meaningful to all cultures and all generations, and we like to help foster craft and design as a meaningful tool of therapy, of renewing someone's self-esteem, but also as potentially as a vocation. I have a painting in the front of the gallery that's called The Glory of the Lord. And to me, that is part of scripture of how the glory of the Lord filled the temple. It was an actual physical manifestation, but a spiritual phenomena, so to speak.
My name is Mark Merrill. I'm a contributing artist here at the Upper Room Art Gallery. I do traditional realistic art, focusing on divine design. Yeah, divine design, it actually goes back quite a few centuries, millennia. The Egyptians use it. It's best known for, you see it in the Greeks, the Parthenon, their sculpture, even their theater, even their writing. Plato described it as the true beauty. It's actually a number, 0.618, in a relationship to one. I've done many portraits, landscapes, seascapes, but I primarily use it in nature, God's order. This divine design is a pattern, an order that scientifically and mathematically shows up in nature. So what I do, like the Greeks and like Da Vinci, I'm looking for it in nature. So I do a lot of flowers, I do a lot of orchids. An artist missionary is very unique. There's a handful of us around the world. We basically take our art, this gift that God's given us, and we go out and use it. And one day we came upon a orphanage kind of hang house for the kids, and we noticed they were making or trying to make handmade paper. And what we did, Robin and I, is help them make better paper. What they would do is they would take, first we had them go to all the different bins and get newspapers, and they knew where to go because that's where they got their food. So they gathered all this newspaper. They knew exactly where to go. We got all this newspaper, and then we mashed it up like kind of an oatmeal. And then we made our own little screens, and then we put the oatmeal mash of the mashed up newspapers in, and then made small little cards, little pieces of paper that we made into cards. And then we had the kids draw on the cards. And then Robin and I in our ministry would buy them back immediately. It's kind of bad business, but it was good art. And the kids were so happy. And then, we'd have some of them draw on them, and then we would sell them outright to keep the project going. And one of the offshoots of the project was that these kids started making money to the point where we needed to get them a bank account. And the wonderful thing is, my wife would take these street kids with no parents, no family, no clothes, no shoes, up to a bank where there was a security guard with a shotgun. And he wouldn't let the street kid in the bank. My wife insisted, brought the kid, opened up a bank account. And as they were walking out, the street kid would look at his picture and start to cry, saying, "That was the first time I've had my picture taken. I'm somebody." So that's the kind of ministry we did with art, making handmade paper and had the kids draw on it.
Well, I think our goal for Upper Room Art Gallery is not too much expansion, but just to sustainability. sustainability is a big deal, especially in America, that it doesn't foster the arts very well. We are, in a way, counterculture to just be a surviving artist and gallery in America right now. We've decimated the school system for decades of art education, so what do you expect? We're left with a shell, and we're left with a culture that isn't very strong when it comes to the arts and respect of the arts or knowledge of the arts. So to just be an artist and have an art space and to be able to be sustainable, that alone is a huge accomplishment. And that's all we would like to do, is not so much growth or expansion or duplication, but to just be a symbol and to just encourage others, go out and do likewise, you know, be healthy, go and do good. It's hard. It's tough, and you have to constantly be thinking on your feet as far as how do you sustain yourself financially as an organization and even as an individual.
Well, if you look in the Bible, the Upper Room Art Gallery is where the Passover dinner was, and a lot of strange things happened, and a lot of strange things happen here. We've done some pretty unique projects already. So the Upper Room Art Gallery is a place where God shows up, and it's a different place. It's a sanctuary. It's a safe place. And people sense it when they come in here. Yeah, we show art. Yeah, we have parties. We have a place to hang. But it's a very, very special sanctuary.